wrestled up under the tractor. Never had one of these off of a backhoe like this. My other machines never had any issues. WD-40 on these. The preservative they put on here. Rub that off. But what I'm planning to do is build a, this is the bottom of the pump actually. When I get under there, there's a fitting that bolts on the bottom of this. And what I want to try to do is let that soak a little bit. There's tough stuff. I'm going to try to build a bracket to fit on my floor jack. I need to do some measuring to see how high my floor jack will go, and then it's just a matter of building a little plate that can bolt onto this. Oh no, what are you doing to me? Little dude gets stuck in there. Well, not cooperating, is it? There it goes. Okay. This is the bottom of the pump, and it's a two-stage pump. Up here in the front, you got the main hydraulics. Back here in the back, you've got the power steering, and I believe, I may be mistaken, but I think the outriggers run off this section. I may be wrong. And then back in here, you got a priority valve, a couple other, I don't know, there may be a pressure regulating valve. I know there's a steering regulating valve back here, but it may not be for the backhoe. This might just be for the steering. I did not study a book on it, so I'm going to leave that on there right there. And spray some on there. WD-40 will almost remove anything. If it has to do with wax or grease or that kind of stuff. It doesn't remove paint, it doesn't remove skin. That's why I kind of like it. It's easy on you. But it'll do a pretty good job getting stuff off of things. Anyway, I need to get under the tractor. And I've got the oil level drained to the point where I shouldn't lose any oil. I didn't drain all of it, but I've got enough out that I shouldn't lose any oil when I pull the suction hose off of the bottom down here. So I'll try to get some shots underneath here in a little bit. There's the pump. Now right there maybe and get some light on it so we can see what's going on. I've got this is the main suction hose, and I should have the tank drain down below the point of it should be low enough I can pull this hose off without getting oil out here. I'm sure I'm going to have some dripping out of the tractor, And what's been going on, I mean, you can see the oil all over, but what it does, it drips on the drive shaft, and every time you drive it, it spins it everywhere. So just, it's making a mess. And there's actually a busted part up inside the front. And if I get time, I'll make one part and show it to you. It's back behind here. This part here's actually got a crack in it. And I've been a little worried about it coming apart while I'm out in the field. And it would put you to a complete standstill. It's not like a hose breaking where you're going to be down for maybe an hour. This would be a major deal. So I'll be happy to have this fixed. This is the suction line that I will be removing. And that's actually where I'm going to bolt my bracket to set my floor jack under here to hopefully make this an easy task. That's the plan, easy. But to do this, I'm going to have to pull the drive shaft out to be able to get directly up in there. And then hopefully, once I get that loose, I can pull it back. Yeah. Not going to be too bad, I don't think. But let's see if I can't get this light up here. I think I can just get by on one side. I'm hoping. This side's easier than the other side. The other side's gonna be tough to get apart. And I'm gonna try to get everything as loose as I can until or before I start pulling hoses off, because if I start pulling them off, that's when the drips start. And it should be easier if I can get the tight little buggers. Try to keep it as dry down here as I can. I don't know if he's got to come all the way off or not, I think. See here from one side. I bet it'll come out of there. Alrighty. Man, that's tight. Them probably need Loctite or something on them.
Well, I'm just a working man's dollar in the pocket of his old blue jeans. I ain't like my Wall Street brother, he's in a bank so shiny and clean. Well, I'm faded and I'm wrinkled, tattered and stained with sweat. But I'm the first one called when Uncle Sam needs a hand with the national debt. I've been wages for the farmhand for driving an old John Deere. I've been laid on a bar in a tavern to buy a working man an ice cold beer. I've been tipped to a truck stop waitress. Paper I was torn, and in the hand of a child I was laid on a plate in the church on a Sunday morning. Well, they say I'm the root of all evil, I bring lust, power, and greed. But this working man's dollar only buys the things a working man really needs. They say I'm worth about 50 cents in this modern inflated age. But don't tell that to the young man slaving to make it on a minimum wage. Or that single working mother, she's been scraping to make ends meet, to make a house a home and keep food on the table and shoes on her baby's feet.
Well, I'm
Okay, here we go. This ought to tighten up. This is actually not quite as oily and messy as I thought it would be. I think it's because of it's been a while since I drained the oil out of the tank, so I give everything a chance to settle down in there. Okay, now I'm ready to connect up my jack here. Changing the design just a bit. I wanted to try to make it where it could come out the side without having to take the pump off under the press. Get these leaks fixed. I'm gonna give it a really good bath under here, so a little more presentable. Let's see here. There it is. Wreck it somewhere here. Expect when I pull this out. I've never pulled one out like this. So far, this is going pretty well, I would say. Oh, darn it, it's knocked the plug out of that line. And then it'll probably start gripping on me. Tight fit. I may have to pull the parking brake off. Maybe that other, I don't know. Nope, it looks like it's going to work. Wow, look at that. Isn't that cool? What I did with that plug. Okay, this is what it looks like where the pump drive is. I thought I might be able to pull that coupling off and swap ends with it, but surprisingly it doesn't look too bad to me. I thought it might have a little bit more wear on the splines, but apparently they did a pretty good job of lining things up here, so that's good news. Everything there looks pretty good. Okay, we'll see if I can get up in there without breaking anything. I think the hard part's gonna be getting the splines lined up on that pump, because I can't really rotate it. Needs to go a new pump on the pump stand, pump jack, I don't know what you call it. That's that. This pump shaft can come out just a little ways. Maybe I can get it started before I hit the bolt. Look at that. Wasn't that something? Okay. See, that's that's the easy way to do it right there. It's basically there. Get this thing out of the way. Cool. That was not as bad as I thought it would be. Thank goodness. That went right. Okay, now just sort all these lines out and clean up some things and put it together. Alright, I'm down to this little hose here and the big suction, or the big suction hose.
Well, they say I'm the root of all evil. I bring lust, power, and greed. But this working man's dollar only buys the things a working man really needs.